So, Laete Omnes, today we're going to look at Book 6, lines 83 through 101. This is the part where the Sibyl gives her prophecy to the Trojans, which is quite spectacular, which I quite like. And then it's kind of some more stuff coming after that. We'll see if we get to that, even though I said. So we start off here with O. Now watch out. When you have that O there, it signifies you're going to get a vocative. O! And remember, she's talking to Aeneas specifically. Of course, the Trojans are there. So, O, Aeneas, defuncti. Now this is a vocative PP of defungor that is a deponent. So having, like, finished the, and it takes an ablative for some reason as an object, a wonderful ablative verb. So having finished the great dangers, ablative, of the sea, finally. So, O, Aeneas, having finished the great dangers of the sea. But, she says in the site, graver, it ends in A, because it's like multa or hike, graver things remain, or graver things of the earth remain. Now, terai could also be a weird locative. Generally, you do not put terai in a locative, but it could be. So, but graver things remain of the earth. In regina levini, so this is the object, dardanidai veniet. Now, watch out. These are going to be a lot of futures here. So, the Dardanians, or the Trojans, will come into the kingdom of Lavinia. Mite, imperative, send this Quran from your heart. Okay? Send this Quran from the heart. But, she says, et here is probably most likely even. Remember, et can mean and, but it can also mean even. But even, they will wish future, not even to have come. Perfect infinitive. So you're going to get to Italy, but you're not going to wish there. She's such an upper. And then we have this really famous thing that you, if you play Rome Total War, you'll notice as well. Bella horrida bella et thebrem multo spumatim sanguine carno. I see, she says, war. Horrible war. And the river Tiber. Spumante, from spuma. Spuma means foam, so this is the verb form of foaming. Frothing with much blood. P-A-P. Alright. Very dramatic. Samoas. And then she's making reference here to the Trojan War, saying there's going to be another Trojan War for the Trojans. Nor a Samoas for you. And these are all objects. This is a dative of reference. Nor the Xanthus River, nor the Greek camps, Doric camps, will have been future perfect, will have been, you say, or you say this translated as future, will be absent. So nor will the Samos River for you, nor the Xanthus camp, nor the Greek camps will be absent for you. Saying there's going to be another Trojan War. Oh! Okay? And then she says, now another Achilles, now, S has been left out, ellipsis is best, has been prepared in Latium, or has been born in Latium. And he himself is born, put that here, from a goddess, ablative. Oh no, there's another Achilles. Okay? And then she says, nor will Juno, having been added, be continuously absent for the Teucrians. So saying again, Juno's gonna be here. So nor will Juno, having been added, PPP, will ever be absent for the Teucrians. And when you are a suppliant in needy things, and you say like, and this is a prep phrase, sorry. And when you are a suppliant in needy things, she says, oh, what peoples of Italy, genitive, or of the Italians, oh, what peoples of the Italians, or what cities object, and this is our verb, future perfect, you will have begged. So like, oh, when you are a suppliant in needy things, so when you're in need, oh, what peoples of Italy or what cities will you not have begged? So you're going to be going around asking for help. There's going to be another Trojan War. You're in deep trouble. She goes on and says, the cause, though, to tell you again, this is kind of very like the Trojan War. The book, last six books of the Aeneid are really like the Trojan War all over again. The cause of this evil, of such great evil, genitive, is a conyux. Is again, each term, a wife, a foreign wife, a guest wife, to the Teucrians. It's a dative of reference. So the cause of such great evil, again, the cause of such great evil for the Teucrians, again, is a foreign wife and foreign bridal chambers. This is, again, giving the idea of this. Now, you'll notice that there's some words missing here. Virgil has some missing lines, and this is one of the things, you know, he died before the Aeneid was done. And you'll see throughout the Aeneid that there are some half lines that people that are missing. Actually, people later on went on and finished these guys, which is kind of cool. So I'm sure if you look in some books, there might be some Latin there. Okay, and then she has last command here. Okay, tu ne cede malis. This is a imperative. You don't yield. And yield can take a dative when it means yield. Don't yield to misfortune. But on the contrary, adverb, ito. Now this is an imperative of go, but it's in the future imperative. Is this a special imperative? Sometimes they end in to. So go boldly, or as audientor, more boldly, and describes you, more boldly, where fortune will allow you, where your fortune will allow you. Good. And then this is the craziest part here. That Aeneas probably, when he hears this, he's just kind of shaking his head. The first road of safety, which you would not think. The first road of safety will be stretched, or will be opened, from a Greek city. So, some Greeks living in Italy are going to be the first people who are going to help Aeneas, and we'll find out. And so that's what we say. We'll stop there. It's not too bad. If you have trouble with it, shoot me an email, or text me. All right. Volite omnes, lingua latina est vita.